Hello, it's Nitro99 again. I'll be doing a review on the new Pharaoh's Quest Cursed Cobra statue. 213 pieces, 30 US dollars, 3 minifigures. And this is a pretty cool set. First off, the minifigures. First, you get the female explorer chick who is. I don't know her name. So if you know her name, please tell me. She looks very nice. New torso. Her new face. She has these freckles beneath her eyes. And it doesn't want to come up. It's very subtle. So, probably can't see it. But, she also has a double printed face. And she has back printing. She has a purse, a gun, and some dynamite. Next we have Jake Rains. Sorry, I keep calling him Jack in the other episodes, but his name is Jake. I like Jack better though. He's very cool. He has a pistol and a rifle that's down in the truck. Back printing. This is his standard torso. Really reminds you of O'Connell from The Mummy in the opening scenes of The Mummy. When they're fighting off the Arabs. Very cool. His hair. He really needs a hat, otherwise he'd get a heat stroke and die. Next we have the truck. It's a very cool truck. Reminiscent of the old Adventurers series. Sticker there. Because the old Adventurers were known for their simple little cars that are charming. I really liked them as a kid because it's a lot of fun to zoom around. Sticker back there, some rope. There's a black shovel and a rifle. And you can seat two minifigures. However, she cannot sit in there because of her handbag, so you have to take it off. There's a new piece in the front. This thing. Can't really show you, but because it's already built in there, but it's a new piece. It's neat. Next, I have the cursed cobra statue. As you can see, this Egyptian guy. Same old, pretty much everything, except he has a new headdress. And he's going the way of Zoom from Prince of Persia, the two snakes holding there. But the cursed cobra statue is really nice. It's going to be hard to pose with one hand, but I'll just give you a rundown. This is printed. It has this plastic-like sheet on the back that came in a special little container. It's nice. He clips on back there, but he comes apart, comes off. And all these little Technic pins, I mean, Exaforce things. And he just slips off, comes to life, and attacks Jake and his girlfriend. Very cool, but it's hard to pose with one hand, but I actually really like this snake. The mouth moves up and down a little. And that's about it. Next, we have the small little holding device for the snake. So stickers, and of course, the scarab. Unfortunately, the scarab, once you put it on there, is really a pain in the ass to take off. I've actually made this video twice. This is my second time making it. The first time, I nearly busted a nail trying to take this off and broke the whole thing. Because this plastic is that hard plastic, which I mentioned in the other videos, and it's just a pain. I figure that it's Mexican plastic because it says up here components made in Denmark, China, Hungary, and Mexico. So I guess China is brittle and shitty plastic. Mexico is hard and tough plastic. I don't know. I'd rather just have standard ABS quality plastic. There's the treasures, the box. She's shooting randomly. Her fear. He's acting like everything's okay. Snake man. And, yep, nothing to say about the manual. I want to say about the pieces, though. I don't know, maybe I didn't put these on, but everything turned out okay. But, basically, I got these three extra plates, which is great. And some other extra lame pieces. But the plates, and I can't see where I had to put them. I don't know, I think it's just, I just got three extra. So that's awesome. Anyway, please rate, comment, subscribe. I really recommend this set. That's it. Bye.